everybody. Today we're going to be heading up to Gisenyi, which is about three and a half hours north of Kigali. I'm going up there with my friends Joe, Solve, and Chantelle. So me and Joe are British, Chantelle is Canadian, and Solve is Danish. And we've all been living in Rwanda for many years, both collectively and individually. And every now and again we do brunch or we hit the road, we get out of town for the weekend. So I am desperate to get out of town at the moment. I've had a bit of a bit of a disastrous morning so far, a bit of a disastrous week. So we've got this big conference happening later in the year called CHOGM, which is where all the Commonwealth heads of states will descend on Kigali at the big, expensive, pretty convention centre we've got. And it's going to be great. It's going to be a chance for Rwanda to show itself off. But in the run-up to this, town council or somebody has decided to build this diversion road, like this bypass at the end of my street. And they've decided that what they're going to do is they're going to do it overnight. So every night from about 9 until 4 o'clock in the morning, every night for weeks, all you get to hear is this. So, you know, I've tried everything. I'm on Nitol at the moment, but it is so loud, it even pulls me out of my drug-induced coma. And that's why I've got these bags starting to form under my eyes and I am struggling to remember my name. So that's why I need to get out of town. I need to go somewhere with a beautiful view of a lake and cocktails, because really, I think cocktails are the only thing that's going to make this better. Yeah, so let's go. Okay, so I love going on road trips in Rwanda because the scenery is stunning. We've just passed through Musanze, which used to be Ruhengeri. It's true gorilla in the mist country as you're going through Volcanoes National Park. Now we're heading further north up to Gisenyi. And the further north you go, the cooler the air gets and the richer the soil. You see stacks of cabbages and carrots being grown here, and also a lot of tea. Just as you come into Gisenyi, there's a statue of two people in a speedboat. Even in a 4x4, sometimes the roads are a bit tough. Me and Joe once had to rebuild one with rocks before we could get the car up it. So this is Inzu Lodge, which is a popular glamping destination run by Marie Noël. You can stay in wooden cabins or in tents. I was sharing with Solveig, and our tent had three comfortable beds and a beautiful view of the lake.
Oh, the swing's new.
I'm just gonna keep taking shots so I get perfect one. You're kind of dark because the sun's swinging.
So I took a moment to nose around the garden. Apparently these are lilies, but I just know them as firework flowers. What I love about Inzu Lodge is that nature follows you indoors. Check out the plants growing in the shower. There are flush toilets on site, but you also have the option to use eco-loos. You just chuck some sawdust down it once you're done. And you can sit and read about how you're saving the environment whilst you poop. This week it was Inzu Lodge's 10th anniversary, so plenty of balloons went up.
Nothing else.
Actually, there's a table over there.
Almost done. They also do a special menu, so you can try traditional Rwandan food. You can even order a whole roast goat, like in my food video. So the next morning, my friends stayed for the anniversary party, but I ducked into town to see a friend. We worked together on a human rights program 7 years ago. You might remember back in May last year, Nyiragongo volcano erupted in Goma. You can see the volcano as you're driving into Gisenyi. It's still smoking. My friend was sitting in her garden when it started, and she saw the sky go black and then people coming across the border for safety. It was a bit of a crazy time.
You see happy dog. You see happy dog. Come on. No, come on.
But everything's back to normal now. And they're keeping chickens, ducks, peahens, yes, and a beautiful vegetable garden.
Come back again. Come back again. Yes, you are little ducklings.
Then we headed to a friend's house for pizza, wine, and two massive Great Danes. Got caught up in a small landslide on the way back and had to wait for a JCB to clear the road. This sometimes happens in the wet season. But we stopped off for coffee at Kramer in Musanze, and that was enough to get me home. I had escaped Kigali for the peace and quiet of the countryside, only to return to this. But who cares? It was a wonderful weekend.